Frost getting us started. Oh. Yushin Okami against Kiamrian Abbasov. Kiamrian Abbasov nice and light on his feet, trying to circle. I like how he's circling to the weak side of Kiamrian, of Okami. Nice little change of levels there by Okami to get the body lock. Oh, I like how he's utilizing those uppercuts to create a little separation.
Kiamrian Abbasov, unfazed by the takedown that Okami got off the clinch, goes back to the clinch himself. He believes that he has the advantage in the clinch, I believe.
Long punches. He just can't seem to keep coming when he throws out those punches, especially that left hand.
Abbasov, a lot more lighter on the feet this round. He wants to use his explosiveness. He knows that Okami is staying a little bit more sharp. Landing his straight punches, Abbasov is looking to loop over. There you go, loops over with a right hand. Lands on Okami. Okami is hurt. Abbasov following up with some left.
Kiamrian Abbasov swarming right now, dropping the ground and pass. Referee jumps in and stops it.
What a victory for Kiamrian Abbasov.
Kiamrian Abbasov lands the big right hand, hurts the Japanese legend as he crumbles. Kiamrian Abbasov jumps all over him and starts the ground and pound.
Kiamrian Abbasov made the adjustments in the second round, was light on his feet, utilized his explosiveness, and landed a right hook over the guard of Yushin Okami. What a performance by Kiamrian Abbasov.
Beautifully done. Check it out. Talk us through
Let's
this.
Let's look at the replay here. Kiamrian Abbasov was light on his feet the whole second round. Bounced right into an explosive right hand that hurts Okami. And then follows up with some left hands. Olivier Cost had to stop the bout. Okami was not intelligently defending himself anymore. Here's the right hand again. Okami got caught pulling his head back a little bit too high. And Abbasov finds that right hand at home. Great adjustments by Kiamrian Abbasov. Was a little bit flat-footed, a little bit hesitant in the first round. Made the adjustments in the second round. Light on his feet. Powerful right hand. Drops Okami and secures the victory for himself.
Let's go to Dominic Lau for the official announcement.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Cost, has called a stop to this contest after 1:10 in the second round for your winner by way of technical knockout, Kiamrian Abbasov.
Kiamrian Abbasov with the biggest win of his career. Does the unthinkable and stops the Japanese legend. Many would consider it upset Gianni Suma, but with that big right hand.
Hey!
In 8 fights, he's never seen the 6th minute of a fight. Nice body shot there though, lands the right hand. Still throwing heat with the strikes. Is Jeff Wong. He's good inside that clinch, able to land knees, land elbows. But Thani just constantly attacking the legs, threatening the takedowns, and dragging the fight down to the ground. Good guard from Jeff Wong. Thani tried to slide that knee pass, but Huang able to get back into full guard.
No holdings.
Jeff Huang had to know that this fight would be a ground war, or at least a clinch war, and he's done his homework in doing so to prepare himself for the ground attempts. But he's getting maneuvered. When it gets to the ground, look at this, slides easily into mount. And this is a bad spot for Jeff Huang to be in.
Thani constantly letting his body weight do a lot of the work. Just leans on you and moves around you quickly. And now the elbows and the forearms and the punches again. And this is what really makes this crowd roar.
Jeff Huang did a nice little transition there to get this fight back into half guard, but Thani was able to get back into full guard, apply that hip pressure, spread out the legs, and just sink those hips deep into Huang. He's not doing a lot of damage from the top position, and that's because of the defense of Jeff Huang. He's really able to stop a lot of the ground and pound, and the shots, look at that, he's able to evade all this ground
and
pound.
He's doing a great job, actually, of doing that. With head movement and blocking the punches with his hands.
He's not really taking any damage to the ground.
Rear naked choke possibility, that's what the crowd are cheering about. Some work to be done first, though.
Looks like that hand is under the neck. Jeff Huang's got a hand fight. He's got a hand fight.
He's tapped and it's over. It's another second round win for Agilan Thani. Five in the first, two in the second, seven wins in total, and Kuala Lumpur just love him. The story continues. It's a very engaging one. People love to read this man's story. Love to hear how he's inspired himself. To come from an unhealthy position to a healthy one, and this was a healthy fight for him, Rich.
Oh, absolutely. You know, I'll say this much, just to give Jeff Huang some credit. You know, a fighter like Agilan Thani, you have to be very heavy on top to throw some good ground and pound. Every time you throw a punch, you're lifting your weight. And that's a testament to how heavy he is, but Jeff Huang was consistently able to push him off.
Another good win then for Agilan Thani with the official decision. Here's Dom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the medal for this fight, we have Mr. Asif Khan, Asia Business Manager Cluster for Chevron Lubricants. And now, your referee, Yuji Shimada, has put a stop to this fight after 2 minutes and 26 seconds in the second round. For your winner, by way of reverse choke hold, Agilan Thani!
Big win for Agilan Thani. He does it again. That's one of the two fights he says he needs before a world title shot. Let's see what happens.
Inside Stadium Istora. Magnificent setting for a magnificent main event. Ready? Referee Olivier Coast gets us underway. Penultimate round. Love to see Kadestam go back to the lead by. Up there from the sweep, but on the back foot, hard to deliver.
I like how Kadestam's timing these knees right inside the clinch. Once he gets the hands underneath Maguire's arms, he delivers a beautifully timed knee, so Tyler Maguire is not able to catch the knee or close the distance to get a takedown of his own. The knees are very well timed.
Maguire looks like he runs a standard trade with Kadestam. Nice defense again there from Zebaztian. Jab from the Swede. Left hook, needs to throw more combinations. No, he did not just rely on the single punches.
Well, it's hard because Tyler Maguire is constantly moving, so he's not there for the second punch.
Slow down that movement with leg kicks. Maguire did believe that he has the striking prowess to finish Kadestam on the feet with the punches. Kadestam overhand right, but unable to cut off the movement of Maguire. Chop walking right hand there. Licks his lips and smiles. Overhand right, caught him on the orbital. Nicely done there from Kadestam. Turning back kick. Maguire caught him. Now he's got Kadestam down, but can he kick the sweep then? No!
His escapes are definitely something he's been working on, and it is shown tonight. Tyler Maguire is used to grabbing onto opponents and not letting go, but Zebaztian Kadestam is so slick. He's utilizing balance, he's utilizing movement, he's getting out of way in an unconventional way.
After 3 minutes remaining, fourth round and five for the welterweight championship. live from Jakarta, Indonesia. You're watching 138 countries around the world. Hope you're enjoying the largest martial arts organization on the planet. Training back in, hoping to find the liver. Upper right portion of the abdomen. Wyatt, Peppers with a jab. No right hand for company, though, from the American. And as Tom showing some creativity in his guard at the moment. Overhand right there. With those sorts of punches. A little bit of showboating now from the Swede. Nice jab. Needed the right hand down the center. Outside knee kick. That's more like it from Kadestam.
That's going to slow down the movement of Wire. Attack that lower leg. Start beating on those legs.
Wire doesn't look like he knows how to check the leg kicks of Kadestam. Striker versus wrestler. Of the two styles thus far, the striker seems to be the one who's had the more success, Mitch.
Yes, he's starting to touch up the face of McGuire. He's starting to land these shots. I'd like to see him keep going back to that leg, because right there, that left leg is hanging out there for McGuire, or for Kadestam. Showboating, he's entertaining the crowd. You're looking at a really good time out there.
Turning back in from McGuire, Kadestam looks to just brush it off. Spin there from McGuire, that was dangerous. Kadestam, though, couldn't channel his inner Mark Lewin. Right hand to the midsection there from Kadestam, hoping to put the belly button through the back. McGuire comes over the top of the turning hook off the right hand, and Kadestam rides the body shot, says you've got to do more than that, you've got to hit harder, Tyler. Do you see this as Kadestam trying to psych out Tyler McGuire with the showboating?
I think he's trying to get into the head of McGuire, and he's doing that because he did miss a couple of shots, and you can see, you know, Kadestam, you know, showboating a little bit, smiling at him, sticking his tongue out, looking up at the rafters. But what McGuire is doing, he's changing his game plan. So if he misses the head, he goes to the body like he was doing. Then Kadestam's forced to go, yeah, that didn't hurt so much, but he's still landing, he's still outpointing. The judges aren't looking at the showboating. That's for the fans. That's for the people watching on TV. But Tom McGuire is not really changing his game plan too much. He's still staying smart. He's still looking forward. He's still trying to attack.
Four down and one to go for the Welterweight Championship of the World.
Nice little overhand right there from Zebaztian Kadestam. But I would like to see him limit the showboating, limit the, you know, the kind of the flamboyantness right there. Beautiful little catch right there from Tyler McGuire, but Zebaztian Kadestam was able to get back up to his feet and keep this thing where he wants to, and that's standing.
Okay, Mitch, let's play coach. With one round remaining, first of all, what are you telling Tyler to do?
Tyler McGuire, he's got to kind of go all out here. We got to see those flashy kicks. He's got to do a big knockout. I think he's behind in the scorecards. He's got to look for a finish. I'd like to see him start punching into a takedown. He's just kind of been shooting in. He's been diving for the takedown. I'd like to see him throw that 1-2, change levels, slide under for a takedown. For Zebaztian Kadestam, I'd like to see him go for the finish, start hammering on that leg, go for some head kicks, and really start throw the showboating aside and start putting some heat on his hands and try to finish this match.
The cage door closes. The fifth and final round from Jakarta, Indonesia. Who will become the welterweight champion of the world? Will it be Kadestam of Sweden? Will it be McGuire of the USA? Inside leaking from Kadestam. Both men have gotten to the deep water they spoke of. Now let's see whose prophecy rings true. Throws him off to Kadestam, hooks off the right hand, just falls short, maybe clip the whiskers of McGuire, goes to the liver, overhand right to the jaw. Left hook, right hook from Tyler McGuire. McGuire breathing through his mouth, evades the jabs, the double jab of Kadestam, a little too slow. Outside the kick from the Swede. McGuire goes to the jaw, doesn't have the starch behind that right hand. Fires an uppercut, went so high, I heard organs playing. Front kick there from Kadestam. Raya looking a little worse for wear, a hematoma under the right eye. A little cut under the left eye. Fakes there from Maguire. And just don't seem to have the power to rattle Zebaztian Kadestam.
Good job, Zebaztian Kadestam's digging for an underhook on the left side. He's trying to pull Tyler Maguire up. Tyler Maguire's trying to attack those legs. If he can lock his hands, he might be able to take Zebaztian Kadestam down. Zebaztian Kadestam's got to try to pull him up, keep his legs separated, keep his base nice and wide.
3 minutes 15 on the clock here in Jakarta. Kadestam looking for Olivier Coast. Maguire wants Kadestam on his back. Get the speed there now. Kadestam. Jog, he's out of trouble. Do you sense any frustration here, Mitch, on Tyler Maguire?
A little bit. He tried to, you know, initiate the takedown, but Zebaztian Kadestam was able to stop him yet again from completing the takedown. He has landed a few. He's got to be careful. He's got to keep his hands up. That right hand just connected.
Maybe another cut just to the side of the left eye of Tyler Maguire now. His face certainly tells a story of the jabs and the crosses and the hooks from Zebaztian Kadestam. Past the halfway mark of this fifth and final round now. Kadestam with a left hook. A right hand though, follow through. There's the right down the corridor. Again, stuffs another takedown attempt. Shot to the top of the noggin there from Maguire. To walk forward, does Zebaztian Kadestam. Have you ever seen him back up? Not in his repertoire.
Tyler Maguire hasn't been pushing forward. The time he's been pushing forward when he shoots for a takedown, and that's when Zebaztian Kadestam's backing up, utilizing that balance.
That feels an uppercut combination there from Maguire. Just doesn't have the power. Kadestam just throwing single punches now. Overhook on the right arm from Maguire. Chance for the knees or the elbows here for Kadestam. He's got great elbows. They haven't come into play yet in this championship match. May we see them now? Kadestam has been smiling, showboating, enjoying himself in Jakarta. Doesn't look like much enjoyment for Maguire. His face is lumped and cut. Hasn't had success with the takedown. Kadestam on his back for any period of time. Locks onto a low single, gives up on that. Kadestam turns back into him, throws a high knee. Under a minute remaining now, jab two from Kadestam. Crowd would love to see a finish. We're in the deepest of deep water now. Sloppy shots there. Nothing on the uppercut from Maguire. Both men fatigued now. 30 seconds remains. Oh, Maguire! How about that? It's over! It's good night, Irene! Zebaztian Kadestam is the champion of the world! Zebaztian Kadestam knocks out Tyler Maguire! It's gold for Kadestam! The bandit steals it like a thief in the night! In the final seconds of the match!
Zebaztian Kadestam waits again until the last chunk of the round to finish Tyler Maguire with a huge putt. Look at that right hand! Catches Tyler Maguire right on the button, shoots in, throws a knee to the down opponent and just knocks him cold.
That huge punch and Tyler Maguire astral traveling. The first loss of Maguire's career, the biggest win of Kadestam. Tremendous scenes here in Jakarta. Zebaztian Kadestam KOs Tyler Maguire in the dying stages. I have injured his knee or his ankle. And look at the respect, the sportsmanship. The martial arts code of honor, the Bushido spirit, That's what it's all about here in ONE Championship. What are they saying to each other? Just two fantastic athletes. Kadestam has done it. And he's done it with a huge knockout. There is your new welterweight world champion. A Swedish champion. Let's go to Dom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Cost, has called a stop to this contest after 4 minutes and 32 seconds in the fifth and final round. For your winner, by way of knockout and new ONE Welterweight World Champion, Zebaztian Kadestam!
And there's the rain of gold over the cage in Jakarta. And the rain of gold begins for Zebaztian Kadestam. A dream realized for the Swede. He grew up on the wrong side of life's tracks. He turned his life around through the martial arts. And now he finds himself at the top of the martial arts world. He finds himself as the ONE Championship world title holder. Emotional outpouring here for Kadestam.